Welcome. Thank you for joining me this morning. It is a rainy morning here. We could use some rain. And it kind of reminded me of how that rain will make the grass grow so much more. And then that in turn made me think of the parable of the sower. And so we're going to share that this morning. And that comes from the 13th chapter of Matthew's Gospel, the 1st through the 23rd verses. The same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the lake. Such a large crowd gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat in it, while all the people stood on the shore. Then he told them many things in parables, saying, "A farmer went to sow his seed. As he was scattering his seed, some fell along the paths, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell on the rocky places, where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But when the sun came up, the plants were scorched, and they withered because they had no roots. Other seeds fell among the thorns, which grew up and choked the plants. Still other seeds fell on good soil, while it produced a crop 100, 60, or 30 times what was sown." And then we're going to skip ahead to the 18th verse. Listen to what the parable of the sower means. When anyone hears the message about the kingdom of God and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what was sown in their hearts. This is the seed sown among the path. The seed falling on rocky ground refers to someone who hears the word of God and receives it with joy. But since they have no root, they only last a short time. When trouble or persecution comes because of the word, they quickly fall away. The seed falling among the thorns refers to someone who hears the word, but the worries of this life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke the word, making it unfruitful. But the seed falling on the good soil refers to someone who hears the word and understands it. This is the one who produces a crop yielding 100, 60, or 30 times what is sown. Sanctify us through your words. Your words are truth, O Lord. Well, this parable to me is one that really explains how God's word works in our lives. You know, it gives this analogy Jesus does of a farmer who is sowing his seed in the field. And you can almost imagine the farmer taking his hand, reaching it into the bag, and then scattering seed amongst the field so that it would grow. But there's certain types of seed or certain types of soil, whichever way you want to look at it. And the first of which is the one that is scattered along the paths and the birds come and ate it, it says. Well, see, first of all, that seed never had a chance in the soil. It never permeated. You know, those are the people who, it says, hear the word of God, and then the enemy comes and snatches it away. And maybe we think that that's not even possible, but yet it is. These are the people who sit in the pews and automatically assume that the word of God is being spoken to someone else. That any time there's a call of repentance, that it obviously doesn't mean them. The seed never gets a chance. It stays on the surface until that bird comes and takes it away. And the word of God with that person has never had a chance because their heart is so hardened. They don't think they need the gospel. They don't want the gospel. They don't hear the word and allow it to permeate and come into their souls. And it does not change the soil because it doesn't affect it, because it has never had a chance. And then, what is it that comes next? The soil that falls on rocky places. This is the soil that springs up quickly, the seed. You know, at first glance, of the four types here, this one is the one that first glance seems like it's going to be the best, because it grows the quickest out of the gate. It springs up quickly. It looks as if everything is going to be perfect for the long run. But then things change. Things get harder, different. Maybe life gets in the way. And soon, because it lacks depth, it scorches it and withers. And unfortunately, this too I have often seen. In fact, to me, this is probably the most frustrating one because of the fact it seems like the Word of God is really getting through. It seems like the Word of God is flourishing. You know, I remember years ago at a previous church, a person who got very excited all of a sudden. They wanted to help with so many things. In fact, they wanted to be involved in all this stuff at the church, which at first it seemed good, but it was a little odd, kind of like going from 0 to 60, a person who previously did not do work around the church, who wanted to start helping and really wanted to be involved in everything. It wasn't even 6 months later that that person then left the church for another church. And the reason was that they felt called, that God was calling them away as such, is what they said. However, there never seemed to be a great depth to the spirituality. See, what happened was some things got in the way, and then they quickly left after a short amount of time. The seed scorched, or the plant scorched in the sun. And we know these people who are the fair-weathered Christians, the Christians who are there in the easy times, the Christians who stick with the church when it's the easiest. Next, we have the seed that falls amongst the thorns. There again, a very frustrating thing. This seed has quite the chance, but the world gets in the way. Those thorns grow up amongst the plant and will choke the life out of it. These are the people that let worldliness get in the way. And I feel, too, that this happens to a lot of us. It's very easy let something get in our way. This morning, I slept late for the first time in a good while. It felt good to do that. However, I didn't get my devotions done this morning. I'll have to, in a few minutes after this, take some time to get that done, or else it might not happen for today. And it's so easy for the Word of God to be choked out because of things in the world. And we are all busy people. And it's okay to be busy. And it's okay to be very involved with things. But whenever we allow the thorns to creep up and to start choking off our life and to choke off our spirituality, we are thus in trouble. And that's why we need to be so rooted in God's Word. Finally, we have the soil that is the good soil. It is the soil that one tiny seed can produce a crop 30, 60, or 100 times what is sown. It is wonderful to see and behold whenever it does well. As many of you know, over the years I've done gardens. Not much in recent times because I learned, much like the parable of the soil, that it seemed like at the point in time that it was to pick the food, I would be off on a missions trip or a family trip with the kids and Abby, and stuff would get away from me. But I remember one year, years ago, this was before I was even married, where I had planted corn. And had plenty of space, and so I planted about six rows. And Grandma even said, "Why are you planting so much corn?" And I didn't think I was really planting that much, but these were very long rows. And I had so much corn, and I remember taking it to so many people, to church members, to friends, how much that was appreciated at that time and place. But it was amazing. The soil conditions were right. There weren't any deer to come to eat the corn. Everything was perfect that one year, and the yield was fantastic. Now, that doesn't mean things are going to be perfect. All of us, I think, from time to time, can actually be a little bit more in one category of soil or another. But I think it's very important that we stop right now, maybe take a step back and look and ask, what soil are we? You know, are we the path where the Word of God just simply bounces off of us and doesn't go into our bodies, souls? Are we that rocky soil that gets excited frequently and wants to do all kinds of stuff and work for the Lord only to find ourselves a few short months later burnt out, upset, mad? That's other folks who's faults and things just didn't go as well as planned. Are we that soil in which the worldliness creeps in, grows up around us? We don't even maybe notice its presence until it's choking the life from us. Are we the good soil that is yielding a huge blessing for the kingdom of God? Let us pray. Oh God, we come before you now and ask that you change us, that you help us to be a better quality of soil and do this for your glory. We thank you for your presence. In your name we pray. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of Almighty God and the communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each of you, both now and forevermore. Amen.